Yes, dear children, today I am going to tell you about dimensional analysis, which is the syllabus of class 11th and 12th. In class 10th, you have read about SI units, okay? But here you have to know about the dimensional formula, okay? So physical quantities are there and we have a specific symbol for them, and the dimensions are always written in a big bracket like this, okay? So for length we use L, for mass we use M, and for time we use T, and for temperature we use theta. So these are the symbols which are frequently used in writing the dimensional formula. Okay, for example, you just take the dimensional formula of area. So area is equal to length into breadth. For this you must know the formulae, okay, which you have already read it till in class 10. So length is represented, length means distance, it is represented by L, then this will be again L, so dimensional formula will be L square. But all the three symbols are used because M is not there, so its value will be 0, L is 2, T is not there, so it will be 0. So this is the dimensional formula for area. Clear? Okay. Similarly, just think that you have to write the dimensional formula for force. Any children, what is the relation between force, mass and acceleration? No idea. I think you have read the Newton's second law, F equal to M into A. To write this, F equal to M into A. Clear? Now you have to write the dimensional formula. So you can write this as mass, and acceleration is change in velocity, on time. Clear? Okay. Next will be, again, this will be mass. And what is velocity? Do you have the idea? Velocity is distance upon time. And one time is also there. So this will be mass into distance upon time square. Now write the dimensional symbols for this. Mass, M, distance, L, time, T. You already know that whenever we take the symbols, numbers, physical quantity up means in numerator, or bring quantity from numerator to denominator, their signs are changed. So what will be there? M, L, T to the power minus 6. So this is the dimensional formula for force. Clear? Okay. Now let us take one more. Pressure. Suppose pressure is there. How will you write pressure? Any many of you have the idea about the pressure, what is the relation between force and area. Any child, do you know? Pressure equal to force upon area. So first write the formula. Force upon area. Clear? Now force, the dimensional formula for force you have already find out, to write it as it is. So this will be MLT minus 2 upon L square. Now do further simplification. So you will get ML minus 1 T to the power minus 2. So this is how to write the dimensional formula. Clear, children? Okay. Now let us take one more. Strain. Suppose strain is there. S-T-R-A-I-N. Strain. Any idea about the strain? No. Strain, the relationship is that increase in length upon original length. This is the formula for strain. So length is represented by L, and upon original length will be also represented by L. So what will be the net value? The net value will be 0. So its dimensional formula is M ki power 0, L ki power 0, T ki power 0. Means it has no unit. So this is how to write dimensional formula of various physical quantities. In your book, many questions are based on it. Now it is your duty to write the dimensional formula by yourself. By this way, you will revise the given formula also. Now next is, I am just going to write how you will convert the numbers, the values from one system to another. Suppose the question is that convert 36 km per hour into meter per second. So how will you convert it? This is clear to you all, children? Okay. Now I am taking another example. So suppose you have to convert 35 and share it. Don't forget it. Okay, now convert it 36 km per hour into meter per second. In lower classes, you know it, that you can directly multiply it by 5 by 18, you will get the answer. But here in dimensional analysis, you have to show the working. Clear? Okay. So kilometer per hour is unit of speed. So first write the dimensional formula of this speed. Speed equal to distance upon time. Distance is represented by L upon T. So dimensional formula will be M ki power 0, L T ki power minus 1. Clear? First write the dimensional formula. Now there is a rule that write this N1 U1 equal to N2 U2. This is the formula. So you have to write this formula for finding the value. Now you have to find the value of N2. So N2 will be N1, then U1 and upon U2. Clear? Now put the values over here. N1 is how much? N1 is 36. And what is the value of U1? Can you tell? Because m is 0, so don't write this, so write L1, okay, then T1 minus 1, okay, upon m is already 0, so no need of writing it, L2 upon T2 minus 1. Now simplify it, 36, L1 is how much? L1 is in kilometer, so write kilometer. Okay, then this is in, you have to convert in meter to write meter. Now take this up, so this will become T2, this will become T1. Now both are positive. Clear? Now further write 36 into 1 kilometer, how many meter? 1000 meter upon meter. Till here it is clear? Okay. Now convert this. This is in seconds, so write second, and this is in hour, so how will you convert into second? 60 into 60 second, clear? Okay, now further simplify it, so you will see the answer will come 10 meter per second. So if you will not do the question like this, the examiner will give you 0 marks. Children, I think this is clear to you. To another question also, one more question I am giving you. To convert 332 meter per second into 332 meter per second into kilometer per hour. Now do the question by yourself. So this is one of the method. Now in our second part, I will tell you more about the dimensional analysis. I think the concept is clear to you all. Like it, subscribe it and share it. Thank you, children.